All right, so we're going to get started with Julie Scoggins, who is visiting WVTM 13. I think for the first time in your career, so congratulations.
I am. Thank you for having me.
Thanks for coming.
It was bound to happen.
It had to happen. You've been doing this a long time, but you mentioned you used to be a regular at the Stardome, our comedy club, but you hadn't been here in maybe over 10 years.
I've been all over the country. Just my path just led me different places. Spent some time in LA and. Now I'm back in the South.
And now you're back in the South.
I love it.
So you're here all weekend. So 444-0008. One show tonight, two shows tomorrow, one show Sunday. So it's a great weekend to come out, check out Julie Scoggins. But let's say someone has never seen you, never heard of you. I've read your bio, so I know you have an interesting background. But how would you describe what we can expect this weekend?
Well, it's just going to be real. Because for one thing, it's too much trouble to make stuff up.
This is true.
You know.
And then you got to try to remember it.
And then you got to try to remember it. Especially, and the truth is just... You just tell it.
Right.
You know, and I talk a lot about, I've been married to the same person in a row now, 27 years.
Oh, wow.
In a row.
In a row.
In a row. And so that's a real rare thing.
It is.
I have some unique things about my life that I just talk about. Like I'm an adopted kid who actually just recently found my mother.
Oh, did you?
And that's not a big part of my act, but it's part of the what's made me so happy and be in such a good place emotionally.
Oh, that's great.
That it manifests on the stage.
Right, because you talk a lot about being a tomboy and being tall for a girl and how I guess your adopted mom wanted you to kind of frill it up a little bit.
Oh, yeah. She sent me to charm school at an early age because she wanted a little girl. She wanted a little sissy girl so bad, but it wasn't going to happen.
It didn't take. You've been married longer than you've been doing comedy.
Yes,
so
7 years longer.
Did your husband always think that you were funny, and when you decided to pursue it, did he say, yes, you are hilarious?
He's the one that pushed me to do open mic.
Oh, wow, okay.
But then when I started getting bookings and being gone all the time.
And it was like, what's going on?
He wasn't very happy about it, and he didn't like getting left at home all the time.
Okay.
So he did, we went through some growing pains in the beginning, and he was, I agreed to book 1 week on, 1 week off.
Okay. Well, that's a good plan. That, you know what? I bet more marriages will last longer if you could book 1 week on and 1 week off.
If one of y'all can go away.
Leave. It would last. But I would think, because you used to be a truck driver, I would think that you were gone more driving trucks than through comedy.
But when we got married, I changed that.
Oh, okay.
And I got a local job.
Okay.
I worked for Frito-Lay. I was a route salesperson.
Oh,
you know,
nice.
The ones that go around with the...
Yeah, but wait, where did you do that?
Well, I did it in North Carolina first, and then I transferred to the Caribbean.
Who does that?
Yeah.
Yeah, and he lived in St. Thomas.
Yeah, and like half of the people on St. Thomas smoke marijuana, so the Cheeto girl is
hot. Very popular.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody has the munchies.
Yeah, they couldn't remember my name, so my nickname was the Chip Chick.
On the, I would want to be the chip chick on the island.
I loved it. And they would be like, oh, look, mine. the chip chick coming.
I can't believe you would give that up to do comedy.
Well, it was a good time. You know what, though? I didn't want to give that up. My husband taught me into moving back to the States.
Oh, wow.
And I didn't want to move back. But that was the deal. When we moved back, I said, I'm not going back to doing the same thing I used to do. I want to try something new. And that's when comedy happened. And I did the first open mic night.
Uh-huh.
And it went well.
Okay. And were you hooked from that first night?
Absolutely. I still have the video.
Oh, wow. From over 20 years ago.
And you can, it's on VHS.
I was going to say, it must be on VHS. Or beta.
It's on VHS.
Well, I'm sorry.
But you know what? I'll tell you something. You do it too, so you know what I'm talking about. You can watch, I can watch that video. And I, from the moment I began my set, I'm not really confident. I'm gonna throw it out there. I'm gonna see if something sticks. I'm gonna see if people like it. And what happened was, like, when I got the very first genuine laugh, earned laugh, there is this look that just happens. I'm like, and it was like you could see like the bug biting
me. Right. You're like, they like me. They really like me.
This is gonna work. I'm not gonna die. I'm not gonna be sick.
You know what? I don't look at a lot of being on TV every day and doing comedy. From when I first started, most people are really, really critical of themselves. You know, you don't like to hear your voice, whatever. I have found I am the opposite of being critical, because no matter what I see her do, I'm just so excited that she's doing it. Right. You know, so it's things that I would change and alter. Say, ooh,
so
never
by
wear
saying
that again.
Her,
yeah, I'm so
you've separated.
I've totally separated. So when I watch her,
thing.
I'm like, oh, look at her up there doing it. Now, me, I would say, okay, not, don't do that again. Don't say that. That didn't work. Don't wear that color. But just there's an overall thing of just, wow, look at that. How bad could it be?
And I have so much fun doing it.
Right, exactly. Because it's a bonus, even, right?
And I hate listening to my own voice, and yeah. I hate seeing myself on video. So whenever I do tape anything and I need it edited, I have to find somebody.
Turned away and just.
Not to find somebody to do it.
So what is it that you, is there something that you haven't done yet in 20 years that you still would love to be able to do in your career?
I've done a lot of really, really good things. I've been on TV out in LA. I did Last Comic Standing.
Yes, right here on NBC.
Season 9. Yep.
What was that like? What was that, from what we see on TV, what was the actual experience like for you living through it?
It is nerve-wracking.
Yeah.
But you're on TV a lot, so you probably would be more comfortable with it.
Yeah, but nobody's watching, so I would be more nervous.
Oh,
about that.
Stop. I'll tell you, if you see the stage, when you watch like America's Got Talent and all these shows that are, the sound stage is so big and so, it's so much stimulation and lights and energy and just on.
That's,
and you just have to, it clicks and you have to jump up and do
it. Right. Ready, set, go. Be hilarious.
And be and on the money.
Yeah.
And you get 3.5 minutes. That was the set.
So how do you know what's your best 3.5 minutes? Does someone else work with you, or do you know this is it, this is my 3.5 minutes?
Well, I actually went to a club in town in Charlotte a month ahead and did guest sets.
Okay.
And did 3.5 minute guest sets.
Okay.
To get that set dialed in.
Uh-huh.
You know, I knew what I was going to start with and I knew what I was going to end with.
Okay. So by the time you got to all that stimulation, you were like, this is it. I know this is the fried, I'd say the fried chicken. Cause you know, fried chicken makes people say fried chicken.
Right.
Yeah, the fried chicken set.
It was
might
so,
be a blank thing.
I was ready. And then I got there and they had apparently coached the audience to clap. To give you an applause break after every joke.
Oh.
I would say it was that good.
Yeah.
I think they coached them because I think they were wanting to make editable points.
Okay, that makes sense, yeah. Oh, that makes sense.
But I didn't have that calculated into my set, into my timing.
Oh, okay.
And they clapped after every single one, and so I ran up, I ran long.
Oh.
And it was very hard. I tell you, if I had it to do over again, I would allow for
all the applause breaks
so I could
for how hilarious you are. You're like, I need to, you know, wait for the standing ovation after every hit.
It was like,
oh,
that.
Well, that makes a lot of sense because you wouldn't know to plan for that.
No,
and
it
totally
really did extend it. And so, but they were good to me. It was a wonderful experience. I'm also on Fuse TV. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you're familiar. There's a show called Uproarious. So I'm on that.
Okay, so can we see you on that right now?
I think you could. I think you can go back and they're on their website online, and they have past.
And you said you're very active on social media. Yes. Julie Scoggins is your website. JulieScoggins.com is where we can find you. But this weekend we can find you on stage at the Stardome. 444-008-0008. And one show tonight, two shows Saturday, one show Sunday. And Sunday is always a great show because it's an early show. It's at 6:30. And so, you know, my director says she's buying her tickets right now. So there you go. There's
yeah,
some tickets
come on.
Sold right there. So make sure you come out and check out Julie Scoggins. Thanks for coming by and visiting.
Last night we were almost sold out, and that's on a Thursday.
And you know what? That's
it
the beauty
amazing.
Of the Stardome. And when they hear somebody is coming, they show up.
Yeah.
Good deal.
Yeah, thank you for having me on here. I hope this will get us some more people. Y'all
yeah,
come on,
it will.
Fill it up.
It would be filled up. Kramer's over here taking your picture, our picture. Kramer never posts those pictures. All right, thanks, Kramer,
yes,
for that. on yours. Okay. All right, thanks, Julie. We're going to make sure we share this on Stardome. 444-0008, Julie Scoggins, JulieScoggins.com. And basically all your social media is Julie Scoggins.
Yep, it's super easy.
Okay, super
easy. Super easy. Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter.
All right, not Snapchat.
Not so much. My people ain't on Snapchat.
Please tell Stephanie Walker that. Her people ain't either.
My people.
All right. Thanks, Julie.
Thank you.